Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BU4U Gaming, and today we are back in Animallica, and I already feel like it's about to, the sun might be about to go down soon, so it's gonna get dark, unfortunately. But I'm still here in the tutorial area, yep. We are just gonna continue where we left off. I'm still kind of looking out for this fox a little bit, because I did kind of close down the game for a bit and have booted it back up, but so far I'm not having... Oh, it's right there. It's right there. Should just take one arrow. There we go. Hopefully I got it. Yes, look at that. And yeah, I'm very bad at doing this, but I should probably get into the habit of doing this again. Remember to take the arrows. If you're using Trank arrows, you are only gonna get a normal arrow back, but they are still valuable, especially at this point of the game. Later on, you usually find enough arrows in boxes and stuff, and you won't really feel the need for it. I've gotten very much into the habit of not picking the arrows up, so I have to get into getting used to doing that again. Okay, but let's actually go over here and see. We have some beer, some rope, we got some matches, very nice. There's actually some charcoal, some straw, nice, all kinds of goodies. Did I have enough timber? How much timber do I have? I have 10. Do I have enough to actually, I need two more timber. Then I can make a bed. I can sleep through the night if it gets too dark, otherwise we're just gonna have to make a torch or something, I guess. Oh, there we go. Yes, that was what I wanted. Nice, let's make, you can just choose to make one of either. I'm gonna make the cheapest one, so let's just craft this. There we go, doesn't take long. Now we have a bed and we can use this to pass the night when it gets too dark to see anything. Very handy to have, and eventually I usually end up making a sleeping bag because it just feels more natural that you would bring that with you when you're out exploring. Okay, so did I skip something here? Kind of saw something last time, and nope, that was that. Okay, so let's just move over here a little bit. There we go, try to see if we can progress just a little bit, and yeah, they have respawned, haha. That's the thing when you leave a biome and come back, or if you start, close down a game and start it back up again, then of course the resources will have respawned. There we go, this is what I was looking for. Yes, we kind of saw a glimpse of this last time. Let's take our axe and let's try and break some of these. I do believe we're gonna get sticks, that's the word I'm looking for, not twigs, sticks. I don't know why I was thinking twigs, but okay. But let's just try and break down some of this just enough so we can get in here, because there are some goodies. Can I get through? Yes, I can. Okay, so there's some steel ingots, very valuable. Alcohol, matches, steel ingots, bricks. Okay, and then there's this, and for that you are gonna need your pickaxe, and of course it's gonna, let's see if we can, feels like there's a little bit wonky with the hitbox on this. Kind of managed to hit it there for a second, but I think this needs, there we go. Okay, found a place where we can hit it. Seems like the hitbox is very small on this one for some reason, but this is definitely something we are gonna need. Oh boy, did that take a while with this poor axe, but there we go, we got a green shard. Nice, and as you can see, it says can be used to enchant weapons and tools from +1 to +3. So this is an item you're gonna need. You're gonna need green shards, well, not green shards, just as 4 different colors of shards, so there's gonna be green, blue, azure, and red shards that you're gonna need to upgrade your weapons. There's actually a 5th shard that has a different use, but those are the ones you're gonna need, and if you find these, then do pick them up, because they're very rare. And you're gonna need titanium dust. Those are the two main ingredients for upgrading your tools. It's not all tools that can be upgraded, for instance, these poor ones can't. It's only certain tools that you make in your blacksmith, but we'll get more into that later. We can upgrade our compound bow, and if we get a crossbow, those two are the only ranged weapons that can be upgraded this way. Otherwise, we're gonna need upgrading kits for firearms if we wanna upgrade those. But yes, these are very, very, very important, and as you can see in here, it's kind of starting to get dark. Actually, some of you have probably been sitting there telling me to eat and drink, because I always kind of forget, so let's just make sure to eat up a little bit here. There we go, nice. It's not the best food at all, these bagels, but it is better than nothing. Okay, we're gonna use this very soon, but it's not really that dark yet. So let's just move along a little bit here. Okay. And we have a little rock there. Okay, we can get some gold. This is nice. We definitely want some of this right off the bat here, because you can turn this into coins. We're gonna need a coin press to find one of those, but once we do that, then we can actually start making our own money, which is gonna be helpful for all the goodies we're gonna have to buy in the future. And yep, right off the bat, always find the bird's nests, because they're gonna give you feathers, which you're gonna need to make more arrows. So let's just see, we need feathers, metal shards, and sticks, so we can make another 12 arrows. So feathers are very, very valuable right here in the beginning. Okay, let's see, what time is it? It's actually 9:30. Okay, let's pick up. See, I got 20 arrows there. That is nice. And as you might be able to see over there, there's actually a gore hound and there's a nest. I don't want to fool around with that right now, because it might suddenly get very dark. So let's actually put down our bed. And if I can hit the right hotkey, there we go, and it tells you in the bottom, hold to place, scroll to rotate, so you can rotate it with any placeable item, you can rotate it with your scroll wheel. And then we just left click, hold left click. I have to get into that habit again also, because, well, it used to be that we just left click, now you have to wait a little second and wait for the ring to finish, and then you just can hold E, like that, to pick it back up, which is a good idea for your sleeping bag or bed, because you're going to want to bring it with you so you can sleep at a different time. But other than that, you just press F, and as we saw, it was like 9 o'clock maybe. So if we say we want to sleep for, well, 12 hours would be 9 in the morning. If we say 10, that's like 7 in the morning maybe. There we go, and it's already daylight. Look at that. Actually, it's 9 o'clock. Oh, maybe it's passed a little bit the time while I was talking. That would not surprise me, because sometimes time just kind of disappears for some reason. Okay, so another little advice here, because we are gonna go into combat. And I don't have my upgraded armor or amazing weapons that I had in my previous series, so I wanna be a little careful. Well, generally you should be try and be careful. There is no autosave in the game, so you have to make sure to save. You can just press F5, and you can see in the bottom right corner it says game saved. That's your quick save, but you have to remember it's gonna overwrite your last saves, like your last quick save. If you continuously use quick save, then you only have that one save, and if you hit a bug, well, then it's stuck in your save. And yes, you can send your save file to the developers, so they can try and fix it for you. You can always email it to them at contact@animallica.net and describe the problem and send them your save file, and they will email you back. But it is always recommendable to have multiple saves. Also, if you suddenly die in a bad situation and you forgot to, for whatever reason you would want to go a little bit back in time, it's always a good idea to have extra saves. So I use F5 sometimes, and apart from that, I always have multiple saves going on. So let's just use this one, and it is just gonna be like that. That's my little system for now. There we go. So you have 10 saves, actually. This is your quick save, your F5. This is the one you're going to be overriding. And if you just want to load that up. If you just want to go back to your previous quick save, you can just hit F9 and it's gonna load your last save. But yeah, it's always a good idea to save before you head into combat, or if you looted something very valuable, like we just looted this green shard, then it's a good idea to save so you don't end up losing it somehow if the game crashes, or if you die and you for some reason can't figure out how to go back and get your items. If, for instance, you didn't have the death beacon on you and you don't remember where you died, you might have a really hard time finding your items again. So, let's do this. We are gonna say Q and let's switch back to our standard arrows. There we go. We can use, you can use your trank arrows to kill mutants. As you can see, it says lethal for mutants. But it's very expensive doing this because it takes a lot of resources actually making these tranquilizer arrows compared to arrows. So do try and use your arrows. But of course, try to avoid using your arrows on normal animals that you would like to save, because if they're dead, as I mentioned in the last video, then they're dead, like really dead, you don't get them back. Then you would have to reload an old save or something to rectify that. So, some creatures are highly dangerous, beyond help, and must be eliminated. We recommend you focusing on ranged combat since melee combat is still very unpolished at this time. This is not so true anymore, actually. But there are certain weapons in melee that are better, like you can find these rare and unique weapons in the world, and currently it's the one-handed ones to go for. They have been optimized so they are faster and do a lot of damage. It's a lot easier killing something with those. But generally, you will often take a lot of damage, so at least until you have better armor, it's a really good idea to start out with ranged and use it as much as possible. Especially, yeah, in the beginning of the game. And then it says, destroying the monster nests, portals, and banners will prevent constant invasions of dangerous mobs in the area. So that's of course the goal, to destroy this thing. You can choose sometimes in certain areas, that's what most people do, they'll leave some of these and then they will maybe build an enclosure around it or something to make sure that they can come back and farm the creatures, because they all have special drops that you might want more of. Like there's some bird, mutated birds, if I could speak, sorry guys. There's mutated birds, for instance, who drop a lot of feathers, so that might be an idea that you want to have a little farm where you can keep coming back and killing them. But at the same time, you want to keep the surroundings safe, so that's why you could build an enclosure or something around the nest. So just do keep that in mind, that if you clear out all these, then you don't have whatever resource they drop available until at a later point when the developers maybe add another biome, and then you might have something available again. But it's a really good idea to think about if you want to destroy all of them. So let's see if we can do this. If we do this, actually, if you crouch, so if I hit control, there we go, and you use your arrows, then your bow actually, or your arrows are going to do more damage. Also, for bows, unlike firearms, headshots count for extra damage. So that's something to think about. I don't know if I can hit this guy in the head, but let's just try and shoot him. Oh boy. There we go, now it's coming. Oh, nice. Okay, two shots. Another thing to just remember here, let's see if I can uncrouch here, is that these guys, what was I wanted to say, now I kind of confused myself a little bit. Oh yes, this is the tutorial area, so this guy doesn't do as much damage and he's easier to kill than they are gonna be when you progress in the world. So do keep that in mind. And before we loot him, because as long as they are on the ground, if you have killed everything that is around it and you haven't looted it, then nothing new is gonna spawn. But if you start looting, then after a certain time, new creatures will spawn from it. They did increase the spawn time, so lately it doesn't feel as necessary to leave the corpses on the ground, but it's just a good idea to keep it in mind. So we have this, but I just noticed actually we have another one here. I'm not sure if this one is active or it's a dormant one like the first one we destroyed in the last episode. But let's just destroy it. I'm not interested in leaving any of the nests in this tutorial area because I'm not planning on really coming back unless I want to go back and check if I missed something. And let's just make sure to destroy all signs of infection. Currently, there is no way that the animals will get reinfected. Like if you cure and tame an animal and then you place it back out into the world and let it roam around, then even if you leave some of this infection around, it's not gonna reinfect them. But I don't know if it's something that the developers are gonna implement in the future. So we got a little bit of gold coins. Nice. And we're just gonna leave you there, mister. I'm sorry, we stole your treasure. Okay, let's just remember to go and loot this guy. There we go, hold to loot. Aha! I am so gonna run out of storage space soon. But as you can see here, I got a gorehound head. Ooh, yes. Mutant trophy valuable to merchants. There are a lot of these items in the world, a lot of different ones. You can find horseshoes, there's like little strange chests, there's like gorehound heads, there's hellhound heads, and other items that have this where it says it's valuable to merchants. And do hang on to them. You can also see them here, corrupted hearts, very valuable too. Because they are rare and it's gonna take a lot of collecting these. For instance, this one can be used to buy some rare tamed gorehounds. It's the only way to get a tamed gorehound is to actually collect these heads. And there are a couple of different ones of them, so you're gonna need quite a few. I think one of them is it 50 gorehound heads for one of them and it's 125 for the other one or something like that? Or it's 75 for the other one or something. It's been a while since I bought them in my previous series, but you're definitely gonna need a bunch of them, so do hang on to them. And yes, that's another reason why you would want to see this is what I was talking about. Strange chest is another one of these items. So, a strange box that seems impossible to open. Some merchants might want it. Mm-hmm. Yep, so definitely something to hang on to. And that's what I meant when I said don't destroy all of these nests. Because if you destroy all of them and you haven't gotten enough of these heads, well, then you're gonna have to wait until they add more to more areas to the world. So do keep in mind that you might want to have a little farm somewhere where you can kind of farm more hits. Okay, let's just destroy this one too. Oh, this is... my head is like overloading a little bit with all the things I'm thinking. Oh, I have to do this and I have to do that and I have to build this. And where am I actually gonna build and what am I gonna do in this new series? It is... quite interesting to start over after such a long time. There we go, let's do this. And I don't have enough to build any more arrows. I only have one empty slot left, which is typical for me because I kind of hoard everything. So I do have to think about finding a way to load off some stuff soon. Then we have like this little thing here. There we go. Ooh, I don't know what was up with my... Huh. Wow. My frames per second definitely dropped when I got into this area. Wow. Not quite sure what is up with that. Okay. But yes, it is a girl game in early access. And I don't have a PC that is perfect for this at all. Do remember to take that into account. I have often considered if I should stop making videos of it, but there's quite a few people who like watching these videos and who kind of told me when I talked about it that they would like that I continue making them. So I'm gonna do that. Of course, I would still be playing the game myself, but it is a lot of fun sharing the experience with other people and discussing it, so of course I would like to continue doing this. Oh, look at that, there's actually a skinning knife. We definitely want this because you're gonna need it to build a tannery. You can find more of them in the world though. Oh, that's perfect, there's a building right there. Oh, I was hoping we were getting to that soon. But yes, you're gonna need this again. As I mentioned in the previous videos, it works the same as with the tool sets. We are gonna need this as an actual crafting ingredient. So do hang on to this, because otherwise you are gonna be needing it, or you are gonna need it to make your tannery, which is where you're gonna make better armor for yourself. But of course you can get more of these in, find more of them in the world. So it's not a big loss if you lose this first one. And then of course we have our campfire. We can build a campfire ourselves, and I could choose to fry the meat. I can make roasted fish and all that stuff, but for right now that is not my main focus. So let's just try and get over to this building over here. So in order to survive, you need to constantly eat and drink. To consume an item, you'll need to place it in your quick bar down here. You can also consume them directly from your inventory by pressing the middle mouse button or right mouse button and select consume from the menu. Yeah, so that's what I've been doing. I just press 9 in this case, and then just left click to eat like that. Or I can go in here and just pick something else, like if I wanted to. What do I want to eat? I don't want to eat anything. Well, there's like little elderberries. I don't really need much food at the moment, but these are edible. Then you can just say consume like that, or I can press my middle mouse button. There we go. Yes. Got all of it. Seems to be working as intended. Cool. Okay, so now we have this place over here. Wow, look at that car. Oh, that looks actually pretty cool. I am just gonna snap a little picture here. So, look at that. Wow. Huh. I wonder if they're gonna go back to that. Originally it was intended that we would be able to drive cars in the future, or like drive cars in the game, but I don't know if they have completely skipped out on that idea. I don't actually mind that they don't, because I don't really want to drive cars in the game at all. But some people would probably think it was cool. And look at what we have right here. Hey baby, you're just sitting there all alone and you're actually sick. Aww, look at you, such a little cutie. Oh, yep, I am definitely gonna make sure to have a home for you. I'm just standing here with my bagel. You want a bagel, baby? I wish I could feed you a bagel. Okay, so I am running out of storage space. So let's see, we have an ice machine, and I can actually choose to store some stuff in here. So that's what I'm gonna do. Let's pop our animals in here. Let's pop this in here. Don't know how much more I'm gonna get of it. We have a water filter, definitely something we're gonna need, but I don't need it right this minute. We have some pretty valuable items here, so let's just kind of pop some of this away, because this is gonna be a little bit of an issue. We can pop some of this food in here. There we go. Let's just pop some of these cans. Upgrading kit, don't need you right now. Let's put you in there. Okay, so we can just store a little bit there temporarily. This is not where I'm gonna be living, so I'm gonna have to come back for these items, but we can store them there. So now we can get metal barrels, pellets. Yep. Okay, let's see if there's anything else around here that is valuable. Oh nice, they've added these here. I don't think they were here the last time I was here, but that's a long time ago. So this is how you can currently sell stuff. There are vendors in the game that you can buy stuff from, but you can't actually sell anything to them. But there are certain places in the game where you can find this. There's one set of these recycle bins where most of the vendors are, or the traders are in the game, but they are also found in other places. And as it says, use the recycle bins to sell items for coal coins. I don't know why it's called coins. Is that a phrase you would use? Maybe? I don't know. But then you can just pop stuff in here if you want to sell it. And that is the prices you can see here. Total value 1.24 gold coins. If I put this in here, then it says that, and then I can sell. I don't want to sell my clay though, but that is how you can make money. But as I mentioned previously, do not sell anything until you know what is valuable, what is rare, what items you are actually gonna need, because money is not that hard to come by in the game at all. So better to you, if you're not sure, hang on to the item, because trust me, you can spend a long time running around looking for something if you make the mistake of selling it, and We do have someone in the Discord at the moment. I don't think she sold anything, but I think maybe she died and lost an item that she needed to build one of the crafting stations. And now she's a little bit at a loss because she has to run around and try and find one of the random locations that this item might spawn in, based on where we each of us kind of can remember that we might have seen it. So that's quite frustrating. So yes, just try and hang on to items for the most part. Aye, nice. Another tool set. Okay, so now we have tool set 1 and we have tool set 3. Awesome. In order to sleep and pass the night, you need to craft and place a bed or a sleeping bed. Okay, can I pick this up or something? No. Well, I got a sleeping bag here, which is pretty cool actually. So now I have a bed and a sleeping bag. Nice. Then we have a locker. Ooh, there's a pistol in here and pistol bullets. Okay. Nice. So I'm actually finding quite some cool stuff here in the beginning, that I must say. I think we can get this gas here. So how am I doing? Yeah. I could craft this wooden box. This is the container you can craft in your own inventory, but it doesn't have a lot of slots. It only has, I think it's 19 or 20 slots or something. So I would prefer waiting a little bit until I can craft something better. Let's see, did I pick up anything that I have in here? There's this. Just so we have a little bit of room. Anything here that's not like a stackable item? Probably not gonna get any more of... Yeah, no, let's just leave it as it is. Actually, I don't really... Well, we could bring the pistol. Yeah. Okay, well, let's actually take you with us. So let's do this. Switch to tranquilizer. He's gonna get upset and attack me, or maybe she. And there we go. Oh. Oh, right. It's a sick dog. We can just pick it up. We don't even have to trank this one. Yep, I kind of forgot about that. And it was actually a male, color black. He's rare. And as you can see, it says status confused, condition infected. So that is why we have to take him to a laboratory. And then we can get it cured up and... tamed. So let's see. They have changed something here. I think the last time I was here was actually a different animal that was here. So that is cool. It's always kind of interesting when you start over in a game like this, that is in constant development, because things change all the time. Okay, well, I think the next building might be right around the corner, which is a good thing because that is actually what I'm looking for. So let's just see. Yep, it looks like it. Aha, they are very close together. So let's get over here. This is the building I wanted to go to. So got a few cows there. Nice. Haha, look at that, a hammer. This is definitely a valuable item too. You're gonna need this, for instance, to build your blacksmith. Again, it's a crafting material, so do hang on to that. We got some nails and poles, some timber, and then we actually have a water pump. You can craft this to yourself. But it's a very handy way of filling up bottles. You can see I have 15 empty plastic bottles. And it's going to give me purified water, which restores 50. This is actually the best water you can get. So let's just fill these up. So we make sure we have some water to drink. We can, of course, always drink some soda or some soft drinks or some beer or something to fill up. But... for now, let's hang on to our water bottles. So, cannabis, nice. It's already getting dark again. Man, I'm taking my time getting through this. Oh, there's the little doggy I was thinking about, actually. Well, I think it was a different color. I think it was a black one that was over there the last time. Okay, but let's take you. There we go. It's a small one. Only takes one arrow, but take into account, some animals are going to take up to 5 tranquilizer arrows to trank them, or to kill them for that matter, if there's something you want to kill, in the beginning when you don't have upgraded weapons. So sometimes they will come and attack you. So Some of the horses you'll find are equipped with riding equipment and can be ridden. To do so, press F to mount, unmount, shift to sprint, and 1, 2, 3 to toggle between walk, trot, and gallop. Yes. Can I get my arrow? Thank you. And we got a little daxhound. Nice. It's a female, and of course she's infected, and she is brown. And then there is the horse we were just hearing about. It has a saddle, so this one we don't need to train or anything. I do kind of want these cows. Where did the other one go? Wasn't that two? Second ago? Huh, I don't know. I'm pretty sure there was two of them. Okay, well, you are probably not gonna like this. Oh, okay. Well, I was too fast. Nice. Ayrshire cattle, or however you say that. Brown and white. Hold E to pick up the animal. Nice. Where did the... Did the other one... Oh, you're over there. Aha, that's why I can't find you. Hey, and you can see the infection on it, actually. There we go. Nice. There does seem to be a little bit of a bug with the animals at the moment. You could see they were kind of just standing there walking in one spot. Hopefully it's something the developers are going to figure out how to solve soon. Because usually they would actually run off the female cow, or the cows would run off, whereas the bulls would attack you when you shoot them. But these would just, they were just standing there. So there seems to be a little bit of a bug with that. And before we get into this building, let's... how much room do I have? Let's just put you there. Let's just say hi to Chrome here. So we can press G. And then he's just going to follow us. There we go. Nice. Which is probably just what I'm going to do. Then we can press G again. And he's going to... Oh. Yeah, there's a little bit of bug with the animals in general at the moment. There we go. So you can see I can ride, and then I can use my scroll wheel. Well, I should be able to use my scroll wheel to ride faster, but it doesn't seem to. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I was already. It's just because he was already riding. There we go. Now I'm sprinting by using shift. Let's turn around. And if I use my scroll wheel now, I'm just walking very slowly. And then I can use my scroll wheel to walk or to ride faster. Nice, I actually kind of want this. Let's hit F again to get off. And... Oh, it's because we're next to a horse. Yeah, I think you're in the way, Chrome. Let's try and remove you. And go back here again. There we go. Sometimes it bugs out a little bit if you're right next to a rideable horse. So, there we go, and let's just get you to, okay, maybe I don't want you to, stop that. Okay, the follow is a little, that is a little wonky. Okay, not gonna be using that. No, I think I might end up leaving you here for a bit until they fix that. I don't use the horse as much anyway, because I feel it is much faster going on foot. There we go, we're just gonna leave him right here. Because I'm always getting off the horse constantly to pick up resources. And as long as you have plenty to drink on you, you can always replenish your stamina, which is the yellow icon up here. Or the yellow icon here. Whereas the horse will have a stamina bar that's gonna go down. And we currently don't have any way of replenishing that. So I generally don't really use the horses for riding, but some people do, of course. And let's see, cloth, nice, and oh! Owning a basic workshop will enable the construction of most of the other crafting stations. You should start building one soon as you find a suitable location for your settlement. There are over 20 different crafting stations in Animallica, each of them unlocking numerous specific recipes. Okay. To avoid glitches, try to build on flat ground. An island like Slashland is perfect for starting a large settlement since it offers a large amount of flat open space. But that is true. You can, however, for instance, the land base, which is what we are going to arrive at very soon, is another place that a lot of people build at. There's not as much empty space, but there's actually a lot of flat space around there where it's easy to build. Or yes, you can go to Sliceland, or very soon, well, I don't know if that update is gonna come out before this video or after this video, but we should be getting a new update very soon, a small one after 2.5, which is gonna add another flat island. So we're gonna have more options, and they also, over the last many updates, they have been adding new little locations to some of the biomes. So they have like smaller flat areas where you can choose to build a little outpost or a little settlement or something. So this is definitely not the only option, but it is a nice place if you want to build something that is a bit bigger, but you do take into account that it's also gonna affect performance if you have a ton of animals and buildings and enrichments like trees and stuff, all stuffed in the same area. Okay, I already looted that. Okay, so this is the basic workshop. There's actually two of these. They have different looks to them. As you could see when I was looking in here, you have basic workshop. So there we go. This is the other look of it. It's more looks more primitive, but we can also craft this one. So if we go into this one, then you see... Oh, just had someone subscribing. Very nice. Awesome. Thank you for that. Let's see. Yep, this is one of the things I want to show. There's a ton of stuff in here, you can see, compared to my crafting inventory. But if we go here, for instance, we can make timber in here, metal shards, which we can't make in our own inventory. And then we have all these storage options, which is actually what I wanted to go for, because these, the crate and the, let's see, the wooden chest, small wooden chest and the wooden box all have half as much inventory space as all the other ones. So I prefer building or making some of these because I want to store something. I'm actually kind of out of inventory space, so let's just use this chest. And let's just pop some stuff in here. There we go. I'm gonna come back for some of this, but it's just so we have enough that we can, a room that we can actually craft something. But these are the storages to use. Of course, there's also these new wagons that was added very recently. But that's the reason why I wanted to wait to make a storage until I got here. So let's just, for instance, make one for wood that needs 10 log and 2 cloth. So let's craft you. Nice. Now we have a lot of storage. Let's just move you up there. Let's move you here. Let's go there. You can place it inside if you want to, or we can kind of go outside here somewhere. Say I kind of want to maybe just place you right here next to the stairs. Okay, hold down left click, and you can see it's wood storage. But it is not limited to wood. You can put anything you want in here. Like I can put sticks and timber and kind of focus on wood for this. But if I don't want to, or if I'm in a case like now where I actually just need to store something, I can actually store whatever I want in here, which I love because it doesn't limit you decorative wise. If you want to use these for decorations and you want to store something other than what it says, then you can actually pop whatever you want in here, and you can store quite a lot in here. But trust me, you're gonna need a lot of these storage containers over time. Yeah, just don't worry about it when you arrive to this and you're like, oh no, I don't want to spend too many resources. You're gonna need them. You're gonna need these containers no matter what. So yeah, that's just a given. And you can choose to change the name. So you can see now it just says it's a container, but we could just say, well, I can call it wood, or I can just, what do I want to call it? Let's just call it Bastion for the fun part of it. That's the name of one of my cats. And then I say close. Now it says Bastion. Yeah, so this is handy, for instance, if you make the ones for plants. And you have 10 different ones and you want to find the one with the irises, then instead of having to press E and see what's in it, you can just call it irises, for instance, and then you know that's the one when you're kind of looking or kind of mousing over them like this, then you will know that's the one you would want. And then you can always just change it again if you want to. So I can just say wood. There we go. Oh, I didn't actually mean to take all of that, but yes, that's another thing. I got a chance to show that. If you want to empty out your entire container into your inventory, you can just press take. So, there's no way of doing it the other way around though, but I wouldn't ever want to do that myself anyway, because I do want to keep certain items on me. But it is handy when you just want to empty it out when you're moving stuff around, then you can just do that. I am going to sort this out in a bit and figure out what I want to bring with me, because I do want to bring certain things, like, for instance, the sticks would be handy because I can make arrows with those. I want the feathers, that's for arrows too. And we do have some metal scraps and stuff. There's probably some other stuff here I want to bring with me. I'm probably gonna make some more storage containers so I can bring them with me to store somewhere else. Or store some stuff elsewhere. But apart from that, before we end this episode, which is already getting too long as usual, you can see there's extra weapons in here you can make. And then you have some extra furniture that you can craft in here. And then there's all these buildings too. There's like different fences. There is certain enrichments here, which has all kinds of feeding troughs. They are just decorative items. They don't have any function. It's not a requirement, at least at the moment, to put something down to feed your animals. There's actually some new ones here, I noticed. Animal feeder with hay with grass. There are some new ones that seem to have been added in the last update, like large haystack. I don't recall seeing this before, so I think this is something that was added in 2.5. Then we have like signal fire. If you place this down, you can mark locations. It means that you'll have a little orange dot on this radar in the top left corner. You can see at the moment there is a balloon in the bottom left corner. That is the general like teleport to get to other biomes, and you can see where it is compared to where I am, so I have to go that way. There's also a horseshoe, so if there's any of these rideable horses in the biome, you'll be able to see where they are via this radar. And yes, you can make signal fires to place down if you want to mark that there is something, like a building somewhere in a biome, then you'll have a signal fire. It's gonna show some smoke if you're looking in that direction, but it's also gonna show on the radar. There's also trail markers you can use to kind of mark your path going somewhere. There's like small spikes and large spikes, but they're not actually don't really have any function. I think that you might do take damage from them, but I'm actually not sure if they have any function against mutants. But I think it's mostly a decorative piece, because it's not like we have anything that usually come and attack our bases. Unless, of course, you choose to settle down right next to an outpost or a nest and decide not to clear it out, then it might be handy, but it's not something I'm using generally. Then there's like a little flag, gold flag with game logo, just decorative, yes. Then there's craft stations. Like it said, most of them you can actually make in a basic workstation. And all of these, even the water well and stuff, are considered a crafting station. You can see the water pump, which we showed just outside earlier. And there's like alchemy tower, art station, and all this. And that is why it's a good idea to actually build your own basic workshop, so where your base is, so that you can craft this, because otherwise you have to go back here to actually be able to craft any of these, or you have to go to Corpse Harbor, where there's a second one of these. But it's really nice to get your own, and it's not the worst stuff you're gonna need for this. You can see we need the tool sets, and there's like a vise. But apart from that, it's very basic resources that you're gonna find everywhere in the world. The other workstations, like for instance, there's a laboratory you can build, so you can have your own laboratory. You will need to build the advanced workshop before you can actually get to that, but that's gonna be a while because it's pretty expensive to craft this. Like you can see, we need 40 steel ingots. Actually, it's probably a lot faster now because you can get steel ingots via killing mobs, so it's not as hard as it was like a year ago, for instance. But yeah, that's a little bit of what we can do. There's some pathways, there's shelters, and then there's all these new settlements down here. Yep, there are 23 different ones at the moment, so this is something we're definitely also gonna come get into as we progress in the game. And well, apart from the buildings we saw further up, there were some houses and stuff. There's some of these actually that give you access to special themed buildings, so you can get some that are medieval themed, Arabian themed, Asian themed. If you build one of these workshops, then that will open up more recipes. So there is a lot to do in this game, actually, more than most people think right off the bat. Anyway, I think I have been rambling for long enough. It's actually getting to be it's middle of the night, which doesn't really matter much. It's only if you are actually out doing something, and right now the moon is out, so it's not that dark. But we are gonna continue next time. Wow, it's the second episode and I still haven't made it out of the tutorial area yet. But of course, it would be a lot faster if I wasn't rambling and trying to tell you guys a little bit about all this stuff. Then I would have been past or out of this area long ago. Anyway, we are gonna continue next time and hopefully finish off the tutorial area, and kind of then we're gonna have to decide where we are gonna settle down. Or at least start settling down, because I don't think I'm gonna go for one big main base. I'm probably gonna have like something similar to that, but I think I'm gonna go for multiple outposts or something in this series. We're just gonna have to wait and see how we end up progressing. Anyway, thank you for watching, and as always, do take care and happy gaming!